going on, everybody? No, this is Waycross. It's fine. It's nighttime. You can't really tell what's going on. How's your night going? Feffery, hi. How's it going? Painful. Well, hopefully everything's all right. Yeah, I guess that could be pretty painful. We're just rearranging the yard tonight. Trying to make the bowl a little bit more efficient. Building up some trains, that's about what we're doing. Yeah, I do. I'm partial to the East Coast because that's kind of where I'm at, so I like trees over desert. SoCal's good though. I mean, I've played on it. It's just, I don't know, I just like trees over top of nothing, you know, like a little bit of scenery. That's cool. I get a little bit of everything. CSX, NS, CP, CN. Yeah, that'd be cool, because they could do the CN route up through there. My hope would be to connect the Selkirk Mohawk region, so basically like from Boston and go to Chicago and come down the lakes and go, you know, go through, come down south and go through Cleveland and then head over to Chicago. That would be cool. Because then you could go through Pennsylvania and go through Horseshoe Curve. Yeah, I think a lot of people would like it if it gained traction and, you know, they actually did it, but who knows? Maybe. It would definitely bring life back to the Northeast routes. Well, that's cool. And Chicago's a bit busy place. I can't imagine being downtown like that. I don't know. I'm more of a country guy in a sense, over top of big city. But yeah, I've been there. seen how much is there. That's interesting. I've only been to O'Hara once, and that and honestly, it was just the, you know, a different plane and go someplace else. Yeah, I'm kind of torn too. It's like being close to work or, you know, being out in the country where I want to be. Good. Let's see. I don't even know how many cars it is, but it's just over 9,000 feet of train. I guess I can look in here. That number there. 152? Well, it'd be 150 cars. Then it's what? That's nothing. So some of the trains will get up to about 14,000 feet once in a while. Just depends. Depends on how much cargo we have and how much yard space there is in the sub yards. Do you play this game? Or are you talking about in real life? Which route? Yeah. I try not to do the monster trains because, I mean, we are kind of sticking to the, like, 2005 to 2007 era as close as possible, but, switch. But, you know, it just depends on what we have available in the yard. Really, that's what it comes down to. I've only flown through the Northern California route so far. I haven't ran on it yet. So do you like to just rail fan in the game, run the road trains, or do like the operation stuff? Okay, nice. Thank you. I mean, really, I'm just... Right, I rearranged some of the bull tracks, so... As of right now, I'm just pulling these cuts out. These are our off-map... tracks, so they have no purpose except to go to the bigger cities or other yards. So it could include some of our AI trains that come in that just have outbound cars on them, or it'll also be our returns from everybody doing the locals in the yards. But we're moving tracks around, finalizing a few things, and making it more efficient. And, yeah, it's going. My thought process is I can't talk about half the stuff I'm doing unless someone's really interested. I just like sitting here chit-chatting and playing a game, and sometimes my mind doesn't think to be like, hey... This is what I'm doing. But what you don't see is we have a spreadsheet as well that I'm going off of, so all the tracks get logged and what's on what. So sometimes if you don't see me moving around, I'm probably filling out something. I know what you mean, though. It's just, for me, it's sometimes hard. Spreadsheets in space. What does that mean? Oh, okay. Yeah, so this cut of cars is going north through Atlanta and then up, eventually going to Chicago, is what's on this set. The next three, you got westbound trains going through Birmingham, Alabama. You got northeast going up to Selkirk, and then I think there's a southbound train that goes Tampa and Miami area. So that's what this is. This is basically our off-map off-map trains. Once these get built up, they just go off the map. And then when they're traveling around the route, it's like eye candy. So that the route doesn't seem so bare when no one's on. For the most part, we don't drive the road trains. I mean, if somebody wants to, they do, but most of our road trains are all AI'd. Exactly. So, obviously they're routed throughout the route, and then when they get to the end of the route, they despawn. And we have the game has the AI generating system, which we have a lot of realistic tags. So we basically looked at, all right, what did CSX run down here between 2005 and 2007? And so we have a bunch of eye candy trains, which is like actual trains that ran, which would be like, you know, like the grain trains, the intermodal and things like that. Some manifest, but most of the manifests come the way across to get sorted. Some of them just kind of float around and go off map, but some of them come in. And then, depending on what train it was, it's either off-map cargo or cargo for the industry, in, you know, like the sub-yards for the industries. So we have a little bit of both. So there's always trains spawning in. And obviously it's random. The game generates it randomly through the AI system. But yeah, so we have trains running around right now. I think these are all off map stuff anyway, or like eye candy. I call them eye candy because they're just trains that make the world alive. It's not that bad. You just, so, I don't know what they're running when it comes to like the map, but just, you know, find a local and then figure out what's on that local and look at the map and see where everything's at and then learn from there. It's not that daunting if you look at it in baby steps. Stuff I'm doing, yeah, it can be daunting because there's a lot going on, but for you, nah. Which one of his servers are you going after? Well, I'm not, this is not this is not their southeast. This is a different community. Just so you know. But, you know, it's still same concept. You know, you get trains in and we sort them and then we send them out to the yards and people get to play with them. That's in a nutshell. I'm assuming you just picked up this game. Jeffrey? I think that's pretty much the reason why all of us came over this game. The limitations. Among other things, but yeah, this world is, it's more immersive. You know, it's you actually get to do stuff where it's not scenario based. And it's multiplayer, so that makes it even better. I think the main thing would be, you know, learning how to navigate through the system, you know, how to get from point A to point B. That would be the main thing. You know, how to request your signals and, you know, kind of know where you're going before you get there. like, you don't need to learn the whole route right off the bat. Like I said, just look at whatever job you're going to take and then learn that area. And then the next job, learn the next area. And then eventually you'll know all the areas, and that'll make it seem not so daunting. And then if you ever take a road train someplace, then you'll learn more of the network as well. But doing the locals and everything helps you learn each section of the route. Oh yeah, exactly. A little at a time. Oh, I don't know. That would be a question for, one of the guys on that server, to be honest. But I'm sure there's, everyone has a learning curve, so. But yeah, just take it one step at a time, and eventually you'll get there. I mean, all of us had to learn when we got on these routes. It doesn't come naturally unless you actually worked on the railroad on these routes. That'd be the only thing that would be, like, and the biggest thing is learn how to control your train. That's the biggest thing is to know how to control it. That's good. Yeah, the depot maps help a lot. Our server, we ended up editing some maps up to the match what we're doing, because we're not using the depot config files. We're using our own from scratch. But the maps definitely help learn where you're at and what industry is where. Oh, right? She's struggling. But those two engines get things done. Nice being on flat ground where you don't have to run 50 engines just to move a cut of cars around. Not too dark on the stream, is it? I mean, the screen I'm looking at doesn't look too bad. That's good. I mean, sometimes, like, if I'm out in the middle of nowhere, I'm not in the yard, I'll, you know, move the time around to make it light out, but figured, why not do night shift for a minute? Yeah, and I can actually brighten those up if I wanted to. One of the developers showed me where the line is in the code to actually brighten them up. But it's not too bad right now. Like you can see down the other end. I usually don't mess around with that too much. I'm usually pretty happy with the performance I get out of it, but I also have a decent graphics card and a decent monitor, so I can kind of get a good graphical, you know, image just between those two. Oh, no problem. We'll be here for a little while. the MFDs. What, you mean this? This here? Oh. You might want to kill your hotkeys for the GeForce then. I don't know how you do that. I haven't even looked at that actually. Yeah, mine's fine. I can change this one. I can change this one. I can change the third screen over there. You know, no problem. So, I'm not sure. I should go check on the pump operation. Still moving. Sorting cars. Just a little bit. We shut our server down over the weekend, so I didn't get caught up. Have a good night. Thanks for watching, hanging out. I guess we can do some rail fanning to get these trains out of the yard. All right, that's where we're going to end the stream. Thanks to everyone for watching. See you next time.